Regrouping, when subtracting decimals, is a common source of confusion for students. This video has illustrations for helping students understand regrouping. Eddie plans to make a tapered steel shaft on a lathe in the school's machine shop. The top diameter is 834 thousandths of an inch, and the bottom diameter is 547 thousandths of an inch. How many thousandths of an inch greater is the top diameter than the bottom diameter? This square with 834 shaded parts out of 1,000 represents the decimal for the top diameter. And the decimal for this square is the bottom diameter. 547 shaded parts out of 1,000. To see the difference in the shaded amount of the blue square and the yellow square, we will use a transparency. This difference is the yellow shaded amount that is left. And this difference is 834 thousandths minus 547 thousandths. There are two full tenths columns. So we have two tenths. There are eight, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 small hundred squares. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tiny thousandths parts. So the difference between the top diameter and the bottom diameter is 287 thousandths of an inch. Let's compute the difference of the decimals we just found by using a place value table. Starting with the thousandths digits, we need to subtract 7 thousandths, but we only have 4 thousandths. Now we know that 1/100th is equal to 10 thousandths. So we regroup 1/100th to obtain 10 more thousandths, and that leaves us with 2 hundredths in the hundredths column. Now 10 thousandths plus 4 thousandths is 14 thousandths, minus 7 thousandths is 7 thousandths. Next, we need to subtract 4 hundredths, but we only have 2 hundredths. So we need more hundredths, and we know that 1/10th is equal to 10 hundredths. So we'll regroup 1/10th to obtain 10 more hundredths, and that leaves us with 7 tenths in the tenths column. Now 12 hundredths minus 4 hundredths is 8 hundredths, and 7 tenths minus 5 tenths is 2 tenths. Place value tables are intermediate steps between using decimal squares to subtract decimals and using subtraction algorithms or calculators. The middle school science club's scale showed that a block of ice weighed 3 6/500 pounds. These squares represent 3 6/500 pounds. The original weight of the ice. 1 hour later, the block of ice had lost 1 7/800 pounds. We'll indicate that by subtraction. What was the new weight of the ice? We'll start by removing 7/800 of a pound, but this square has only 6/500. So we replace one whole square by a square with 100 hundredths. Now we have 100 6/500. Then we remove or take away 7/800, which we can show by blocking out 7/800. And this leaves 2,200 6/500, so a total of 8,700 remain. Then to subtract the 1 in 1 7/800, we remove 1 unit square. So 1 and 87 hundredths remain. So the new weight of the ice is 1 and 87 hundredths pounds. The algorithm for computing this difference is similar to the steps with the decimal squares. We want to subtract 8 hundredths, but we only have 5 hundredths, so we regroup 1 tenth to gain 10 more hundredths, and this leaves us with 5 tenths in the tenths column. 10 and 5 is 15, and 15 minus 8 hundredths is 7 hundredths. Then we need to subtract 7 tenths, but we only have 5 tenths, so we regroup 1 unit to gain 10 more tenths, and this leaves us with 2 units in the units column. 15 tenths minus 7 tenths is 8 tenths, and 2 minus 1 is 1, so 1 and 87 hundredths is the new weight of the ice. Notice in the algorithm that we subtracted the hundredths digits and then the tenths digits. But in using the squares, we subtracted 78 hundredths in one step. Blaine walked 8 tenths of a mile along a river. If the length from 0 to 1 on the number line represents 1 mile, we can represent the distance Blaine walked by drawing an arrow from 0 to 8 tenths. Then Blaine returned 5 tenths of a mile along the same path, stopping at a bridge. Starting at 8 tenths on the number line, a second arrow can be drawn back towards 0, 5 tenths. How far is Blaine from the starting point? The difference between these distances is 3 tenths. So 8 tenths minus 5 tenths equals 3 tenths. And Blaine is 3 tenths of a mile from the starting point. Moving forward on a number line to represent one amount, and then moving back towards 0 to represent a second amount, is one method of showing subtraction of decimals on the number line. Next, we look at a different method of showing subtraction of decimals on a number line. The circular opening for a bluebird's house has a diameter of 1 and 56 hundredths inches. The opening for a sparrow's house is 1 and 18 hundredths inches. What is the difference in these dimensions? Let's draw an arc to represent the opening of the bluebird's house. And an arc to represent the opening of the sparrow's house. The difference in these mixed decimals can be found by counting the hundredths between the arrows. We can either count back or we can count forward using the add-up method. Starting at 1.18, it's 2 hundredths to 1.2. From 1.2 to 1.5, it's 3 tenths or 30 hundredths. And from 1.5 to 1.56, it's 6 hundredths. So the total difference is 38 hundredths. And 1 and 56 hundredths minus 1 and 18 hundredths equals 38 hundredths. So the difference in the dimensions of the openings for the two birdhouses is 38 hundredths of an inch. you have seen place value tables and number lines for illustrating subtraction of decimals and mixed decimals. And special attention was given for understanding regrouping. A demonstration of a game shooting laser beams at asteroids from decimalsquares.com.
The object of this game is to shoot laser beams at asteroids. We'll choose the intermediate level, which involves rounding decimals and computing sums and differences. Nice shot. This takes some concentration. Here we have a difference. Good shot. 6 out of 7. Successful shot.